Masechet Zvachim, page 63, the Mishnah, three lines from the top of the page. We finished the perek Ezeu Mekoman Shel Zvachim. Now we start the perek Ezeu Mekoman Shel Menachot. Here we are continuing with the idea that the same manner that we discussed Zvachim, here we're dealing with the Menachot, the meal offering. And the Mishnah said, "Menachot hayu nikmatzot bechol makom ba'azara." Unlike previously, we learned that there are certain item needs to take place specifically in the northern part of the temple courtyard. Here, the handful it were removed from the meal offering can be any place, even that is a kodesh kodashim, even that it's the most sacred one. Ve'ne'echalot lifnim min ha'kla'il, and they can consume within the area enclosed by the curtain, lezichrei kehuna, which is male of the priesthood. And here Rashi tells us, dechtiv lechol korbanam ulechol minchatam ulechol chatotam ve'samich le bekodesh ha'kodashim tochlenu kol zachar yochal oto. You see here a very clear statement that has to be by male of the priesthood, and they said bechol ma'achal. So bechol ma'achal, the idea is that excluding chametz, you can do it in any form of a food preparation that it chooses, which is roasted or boiled, leyom v'alayla ad chatzot, day a night until midnight. Rashi tells us, "Leyom v'alayla de'alfinan meminchat lachmei toda," because it's also some type of mincha. Gemara. Amar Rabbi Elazar, mincha shenikmetza b'heichal kshera. So here we say that a meal offering that had its handful removal from the sanctuary, so it's important to know that it's betoch haichal, not ba'azara. So it's valid. Sheken matzinu besiluk bezichim. We found with regard to removal of two bowls of levona that were placed beside the lechem apanim, the shoe bread, on the table, which was located in a sanctuary. So here we learn that was at that time on Shabbat, there are these bowls of levona were removed and burned on the altar, which allowed the shoe bread to be eaten. So removal of that bowl of levona paralleled the process of removing a handful from a meal offering. Just as the removal of the bowl took place in a sanctuary, so could the removal of a handful of the meal offering be done in a sanctuary. Metiv Rabbi Yirmiyah, that's the book of Vayikra, chapter 2, Pasuk 2. Ve'evi'a al bnei Aaron ha'kohanim ve'kamatz misham. Pasuk said, and he shall bring it to Aaron's sons, the priests, and he shall take from there his hands full. So from there, what does that mean? Mimakom shiraglei hazar omdot. That apply that the handful must be taken from a place where the feast of the non-Kohen who brought the meal offering may stand, which is obviously the temple courtyard, but not the sanctuary, in direct contradiction to the opinion of Rabbi Elazar. So here is Rashi. He tells us a very interesting Rashi.
לאל כהה והביא עזר אל בני ארון הכהנים וקמת משם ולא קומצו, משמע ממקום שהבעלים עומדים שם. וכסל על התח השתה לאסור בין האולם קאטי שאין זר נכנס לשם.
So
So the continuation of the Braita, Ben Beteira Omer. So the whole idea of Kmitza on the left hand is invalid. Minayin shim kamatz bismol shiya chazir veikmotz beyamin. How do you know that if the Kohen removed the handful with his left hand, he should return the handful to the vessel and then remove another handful with his right hand? Talmud lomar mi sham. The Pasuk said, and he shall take from there his handful. Mi makom shekamatz kvar. That he take from a place where he's already removed a handful. Another option, Ika de Amrei. Hu motiv la vehu mefarek la. Which means, this is Rabbi Yirmiyah that challenge, bring the question, and he is also one who give the terutz, the explanation. Ika de Amrei, there are those who said Rabbi Yaakov is the one who give the explanation. Amar lei Rabbi Yaakov le Rabbi Yirmiyah bar tachlifa. Call him by his father's name. Asbera lach. I want to explain it to you, this solution. The Pasuk did not come to bring exclusion for the Kmitza b'echal, because Kmitza, the handful, it's befitting there. Lo nitzrecha ela leachshir kol ha'azara kula. It's necessary to render the entire temple courtyard valid for removing the handful, but not to indicate that one may not take the handful in a sanctuary. Salka da tachamina hoil v'ola kodshei kodashim u'mincha kodshei kodashim. Since both burn offering and meal offering, they are both sacred, most sacred order. Ma ola tu'unat zafon, af mincha tu'unat zafon. The same way as we learned yesterday and the day before yesterday, that burn offering required to do it in the northern side of the temple courtyard. The same applies to a meal offering that have to be in the north side of the temple courtyard. So the Gemara said, no, ma le'ola, can compare it, you know why? Sheken kalil. Part of the requirement in ola, in a burn offering, is the total, complete burn on the altar. So you cannot have the right that the same as burn offering must be slaughtered in the north side, so the handful the same, it's different. So you learn from a sin offering, mechatat, ma lechatat sheken mechaper al chayvei kritut. So because it's atone for those who are liable to receive kritut, me'asham, guilt offering. Again, different, ma le'asham sheken minei damim, because when it's come to a guilt offering, that the sacrificial right to perform with the blood, which is not with the regular regard with the meal offering, mikulho, it could also cannot be suggested to draw an analogy from the common element shared by all the offering mentioned before. Why malekulho, all of them, sheken minei damim, that they are all type of offering whose sacrifice rite are performed with the blood. Ela itzterich salcha data chamina oil v'katav v'higisha ela mizbeach v'erim menu bekumtzor ma agasha bekerem maravi dromit ak mitza bekerem maravi dromit. The same way as they bring the meal offering, they have to be in southwest corner of the altar, the same way as the removal of the handful must be the same way, the southwest of the corner of the altar. So therefore, kamash melan, that the removal of the handful may take place anywhere in the temple courtyard. Omar Rabbi Yochanan, shlamim sheshachatan ba'echal, peace offering that was slaughtered in the sanctuary, ksherim, they are valid, shenemar v'shachato, oto petach o'el moed, they shall slaughter it in the entrance of the tent of meeting. That's Leviticus 3. Ve'lo yehet tafel chamur min ha'ikar, which is the secondary sanctity, should not be a greater than the place of primary sanctity. So it means because the offering is valid if it was slaughtered in a courtyard, it's certainly that it's valid if it's slaughtered in a sanctuary. Meitiver Rabbi Yochanan ben Beteira omer, minayin shehim ikifu ovdei kochavim et kol ha'azara. So here we ask that those evil people, that those surrounded the entire temple courtyard and the attacking, here the Mefarshim said, Yorim chitzim blistraot rashis betocha. So the Kohanim cannot enter there to eat the most sacred one. שהכהנים נכנסים לשם ואוכלים משם קודשי קודשים, תלמוד לומר בקודש הקודשים יאכלנו. The most holy place של eat, באמה, אינמה בחצר אומר יאכלוה, ולא יטפל חמור מן העיקר, אומרת הגמרא, החיישת? How do you compare it? האטם עבודה דאדם עובד במקום רבו, over the person serves in presence of his master. אמרינה, לא יטפל חמור מן העיקר. אכילה עד אין אדם אוכל בפני רבו. When it's come to eating a sacrificial food, it's totally different. Because a person does not eat in the presence of his master, we do not say the rationale that the place of the secondary sanctity should not be greater than the place of primary sanctity. Lo yehet tafel chamur min haikar lo amrinan. So as you see, consequently, we have the pasuk that require that the Kohen may partake of the offering in a sanctuary. Here we are in the Mishnah, that dealing with the exact place that you have to have the avodat chatat ha'of. Chatat ha'of, the sacrificial of a bird sin offering, haitan na'aset, was performed al keren dromit ma'aravit, in the southwest corner of the altar. It's basically three peulot. It was melika, haza'ah, and mitzui. ובכל מקום הייתה קשרה, אלא זה הייתה מקומה. So basically it can be anywhere, but this was the designated place. ושלושה דברים הייתה אורה קרן משמשת מלמטה, ושלושה מלמעלה. So there are three matter with which the portion of the corner above the red line, חוט הסקרה, served as the proper location. So they said, מלמטה חטאת העוף והגשות ושירי אדם, under, below, is sacrificing a bird, sin offering, bringing a meal offering near the altar before the removal of the handful, and pouring out the remaining blood, ומלמעלה ניסוך היין והמים ועולת העוף כשהיא רבה במזרח. כל העולים למזבח עולים דרך ימין, anything that come to the altar, ascend to the right, and we learn it, if you remember, both in Sukkah 48b and other places, when the Kohen entered to the Rosh HaMizbeach, he goes to the right way. We learn it in the previous daf in 62. So as always, Yimin Hashem Osa Chayil, Yimin Hashem Romema, it's always toward the via to the right. Everyone who ascend, the Rambam said, the altar does so via right side of the ramp, circles the altar counterclockwise, and descends via left side of the ramp. So this is halacha with exception of one ascending for one of three matters that are performed atop the altar on its southwest corner. In these instances, one ascends via the left side of the ramp, immediately turns left to the southwest corner, and upon completing the right, retracts his steps and descends the ramp. That's basically follow the Mishnah, and it's the Rambam, Hilchot Maaseh HaKorbanot, chapter 7.
Page 63b, ומקיפין ויורדים דרך שמאל.
So here the Kohen needs to do, for example, Matan Dmei Chataot. So he needs to go around circle in order to reach the place that he needs to do the avodah, which is the southwest corner. Chutz min ha'ole lishlosha elu, except one who ascend for one of these three manners, shehayu olim ויורדין על העקב. So they will ascend and descend on their heels in the same way that they went to. So it's important to know that when a Kohen will complete his avodah at the southwest corner, he will be facing the north of the altar. In order to descend the ramp, he needed to run right to the south of the altar toward the ramp. So now the Gemara looking for the source of the Mishnah that this bird, the Chatat HaOf, it was in the southwestern of the altar. Menah Hanimile, from her word you know it. Amar Rabbi Yoshua, some said Amar Rabbi Lazar. Amar Kra, the Torah said in Vayikra chapter 5 verse 11, in regards to Minchat Chote, one who needs to bring a bird sin offering, so the Torah said, Lo yasim alea shemen, ולא ייתן עליה לבונה כי חטאת היא. He shall put no oil upon it, neither shall he put any לבונה on it, for it is a sin offering. So what do you see from the pasuk? They use the word חטאת קרויה מנחה, ומנחה קרויה חטאת. Why? Because the pasuk said כי חטאת היא. So you see that the sin offering is called meal offering and vice versa. Ma chatatu na tzafon, the same way as a sin offering require no. Af minchatu na tzafon, same in meal offering. Uma mincha bekeren ma'aravid romi, the same way as a meal offering at the corner of southern west. Af chatat, so the blood of the sin offering is sprinkled where? Bekeren, at the corner, ma'aravi dromi, southwest of the altar. U'mincha gufa menala. How do you know that the mincha itself, the meal offering, we dwelt where? At the southwest corner. Detanya lifnei Hashem. Yachol b'ma'arav, Talmud lomar el pnei ha'mizbeach. I el pnei ha'mizbeach yachol b'darom, Talmud lomar lifnei Hashem. הכיצד מגישה בקרן מערבית דרומית. So the Kohen brings it near at the southwest corner of the altar. כנגד חודה של קרן ודיו. Opposite the edge of the corner of the altar. And that's sufficient. So then it fulfilled the two psukim. Because in this way the meal offering is both the west and the south of the altar. Not everyone agree with that. Rabbi Elazar Omer, since the pasuk said clearly that you have to have the two sides of the altar, yachol yagishena lema'arava shel keren o lidroma shel keren, maybe you bring it near the altar to the west of the southwest corner, or to the south of the southwest corner. Amarta, you should say, kol makom shata motze shne mikraot, anytime you see two psukim that apparent as a contradiction, verses, echad mekayem atzmo umekayem chaveiro. So one of them fulfill itself, which is the requirements stated in the pasuk, and fulfills the requirement stated in the other verse, which means the acting according to with the other one of them fulfill itself and negates the requirement stand in the other pasuk. Echad mekayem atzmo umekayem chaviro, veechad mekayem atzmo umevatel chaviro, negate the other. Even you don't explain it in the pshat, manichim ze shemekayem atzmo umevatel chavero vetofsim et shemekayem atzmo umekayel chavero. So here we go to the in this context. Kshata omer al pnei Hashem b'marav, when you said before the Lord and you said that in the west side of the altar, היכן קיימת על פני המזבח? How do you fulfill in the front of the altar? וכשאתה אומר על פני המזבח בדרום, said in you do it in the south side, in the front of the altar, קיימת לפני השם, you do before the God. So consequently, the meal offering must be brought near the south side of the altar. בדרום, היכן קיימת? How do you do it in the south side, near the altar? אומר רבה שיקה סבר היתנה, כולי מזבח בצפון קאי. The Tana hold that the entire altar stood in the north section of the temple courtyard. So it was basically directly aligned with the midpoint of the temple courtyard, directly opposite the entrance of the sanctuary, and therefore it considered before the Lord. Then the Mishnah said, "Bechol makom hayta avodat chatat ha'of kshira, ela ze hayta mekoma." Ze meaning the southwest corner. Maika amar, what exactly the Mishnah meant to say. Amar Rav Ashi achi kamar b'chol makom hayta kshira limlikata. Any place was valid, was kosher for pinching. However, ela ze, the southwest corner, haya mekoma lehaza'ata. It was the place for the sprinkling of its blood. Tanina leha de tanura banan. Melaka bechol makom b'mizbeach kshera. Pinch in any place in the altar, it's valid. Hizadama bechol makom kshera. Sprinkle the blood, any place, it's okay. Hizav velo mitza. Sprinkle, but is not squeezed out. The remaining of the blood upon the lower part of the wall of the altar. Ksheira, it's okay, but it's a condition. Ubilvad sheyeh michut hasikra ulmata midam hanefesh. So the place some of the blood of the soul anywhere on the altar from the chut hasikra, the red line, and below. So that's basically dam mekaleach mitzavar haof. So we explain that there are three types of dam. We talk about dam ha-mekaleach, shanefesh, dam ha-nefesh, melika. That's the blood that nefesh yotza bo, dam ha-nefesh. Remember, we talk about it on page 25. Mai kamar, what exactly mean to say? Because the beginning of the brayta, they say that azaat adam, bechol makom kshira, it's okay in any place, even above the red line, above the chut ha-sikra. And then we said, מחוט הסקרה ולמטה כשרה. הכי כמר, מלקה בכל מקום במזבח כשרה. If he pinched, it snapped. In any place in the altar, it's valid. מצד דמה בכל מקום במזבח כשרה. If he squeezed out the blood in any place in the altar, it's valid. Because מיצוי, the squeezing, it's not me'akev. This is Sfat Emet in that. Anyway, just let's few lines from 64. She'im hizav velo mitzak she'ira. If he sprinkled the blood but did not squeeze out the rest of it, it's still valid. Ubilvad, there is a condition. She'iten mechut hasikra ulemata. That he places some of the blood of the soul anywhere on the altar from the red line and below midam hanefesh. So therefore, the dam hanefesh chatat kshera, even if he's not squeezed, if he's not mitzah tshiyarei adam. There is a book called Chok Natan that expands to that. Obviously, it's running out of time. I just want to make one point, if you don't mind, just very short point. סרדי זבו כל חיים וברכה על הלכות ארבעת המינים, עוד ריש סמך.
So he bring teshuva, he bring a response from the famous Maharsha Mibrazan Zatzal. So here we try just to digress for a second, we talk about etrog. So there is a notion that said, nital hapitam kasher. So he discuss, אם פוסל ביש עליו חזזית, או נקודות שחורות או לבנות, כיוון שחסר כשר, מנומר. So they bring the source from our Gemara, he said, מצד אמה בכל מקום המזבח כשרה, שהיא מיזה ולא מצד כשרה, ולמעשה לא הקל. So this is a response הכל, שלא דו תשובות קניין תורה, חלק א', סימן מבית. אני bring the ביור הלכה, סימן סמך בית. So he said, someone betrothed a woman, קידש אישה שלא מדובר באותה מדינה, meaning not the language of that land, so אינה מקודשת. So he asked, he said, אבן העזר, כף זין, said, bring the רמה, קידש בשתיקה, שניהם מודים, ספק קידושים. So he bring the חתם סופר, יורד הרי שעין וב, that said that's based on our סוגיה. Just reading the חתם סופר. דנאי די יש לומר דן צריכים עמודים בספר תורה מכל מקום מסע לעמודים מנהלה שלא יהיה מנה מותר בפיך רק משבת פשיט על השס דקול מקרא דין הרי נעשה אפילו מה שאינו מותר בפיך ויש להשוות שלא יסתירה ממקום למקום ועל כל פנים יש מקום בסברה נעל זה בלשון אחרת גרם משתיקה so that's based on what we said here the end of the sugya זה מצד אמה בכל מקום מזבח כשרה שהיא מזה ולא מיצה כשרה But as we said, it's way more to discuss on this sugya, maybe another time.